the Elite Student Athlete Pathway Program is basically where we work with our 42 member universities throughout Australia just to enhance the support and services that they provide to elite student athletes in their programs. There's over 4,700 elite student athletes throughout the country, as I said, at 42 universities, so it's quite a big network of students and people that work in that space. So the students, there are some core requirements that they have to meet. Generally, they have to be within a professional team in the professional sporting code. So your footballs, your Australian rules football, rugby leagues, netballs in Australian sport. Or they're a member of the national governing body for that sport within their high performance, that sport's high performance pathway. So whether it's Athletics Australia, Cycling Australia, Swimming Australia, athletes have to be a member of that sports pathway to receive support. Yeah, look, it's a common issue we find, particularly from some academics and that work in the university industry, that they sometimes don't want to give that support to the elite athletes because they feel that the elite athlete doesn't deserve it. Our argument to that typically is that the elite athlete can also give back to the university through numerous different ways they can do that. Obviously, if and when they represent Australia at an elite international competition, or if they're in a professional code and representing a professional team, that they can regularly refer to the support and access to support, and be an ambassador for the university. Yep, probably the biggest one would be just a lack of time. Obviously, elite athletes are busy people. They're training for their sport, trying to also manage some family time within all that. So having a lack of time makes it hard for them to focus on doing their study commitment. Dual career, I think it's important. Some interesting themes we've actually found in Australia is that obviously dual career helps the athlete through what they want to do post-retirement from competitive sport, but we've also found that it actually benefits the athletes whilst they're still competing, so it benefits their performance levels as well. So I'll be talking a little bit about that. I'm also interested in hearing the other several speakers that'll be discussing dual career tomorrow.